I'll give you some scriptures wherever you are. From verse 6. Maybe we can read from 21 to 17. Yes, 17. Let me read. It says, verse 7, from 6 years. Then the disciples went and did as Jesus had instructed them. And they brought the donkey and the colt and placed their coats on them. And Jesus sat on the coats. Most of the crowd spread their coats on the road as before the king, while others were cutting branches from the trees and spreading them on the road. Verse 9, and the crowd that went ahead of him and those that followed him were shouting in praise and adoration, Hosanna to the Son of David, Messiah. Blessed or praise be glorified is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest heaven. If we read verse 10, it says, when he entered Jerusalem, all the city was trembling with excitement, saying, who is this? And the crowds were saying, this is the prophet Jesus from Nazareth in Galilee. 12, and Jesus entered the temple grounds and drove out with force all the way buying and selling and in temple area. And he turned over the tables of the money changers and then the chairs of those who were selling doves and doves for sacrifice. Jesus said to them, it is written in the scripture, my house shall be called a house of prayer, but you are making it a robbers of dead. And as you can see there, when we have read, I want us to look at this verse 15. But when the chief priest and the scribes saw the wonderful and miraculous things that Jesus had done, and heard the boys who were shouting in praise and adoration, Hosanna to the Son of David, they became indignant. And they said to him, do you hear these children, what these children are saying? And Jesus replied to them, yes, have you never read in the scripture, out of the mouth of infants, the nursing babies, you have prepared and provided praise for yourself. Then he left them and went out of the city to Bethany and spent the night there. Amen.
Amen.
I want us to look at the scriptures. I'll be giving you scriptures. Viewers at home, I want to give you scriptures. I was looking at the situation we are in now, and I began to ask myself, what if Jesus was around? And I realized that, you know, they were supposed to be still going to be places. If Jesus was around, you could still hear more of praise than more of sickness. You know, here you could see that Jesus spent more time outside of Jerusalem. And by the time when he came to Jerusalem, we normally talk about the triumphal entry. You could hear how he prepared himself to enter and get a coat. But you could see what was happening inside Jerusalem. You know, Jesus spent more time outside of Jerusalem. And then you could see what was happening inside Jerusalem. When Jesus Jesus is absent in Jerusalem, the church was not representing him. But the moment when he entered Jerusalem, he said, he drive all the people who have changed the church. Always the sin was promoted in that church to extend that people, the business of sacrificing was rising than the business of having Jesus in their lives. So you could see the difference of what happened. To extend that when Jesus returned, he drove all of them. Because he knew that he was the sacrifice. He drove all of them. The Bible says when he drove all of them, he said, this house, when Jesus is sacrificed, is going to be the house of prayer. Today, our buildings are no longer showing that it's a house of prayer because of sickness. But there's something that I want us to look at, because what I want to talk about is we are not supposed to be silent. We are not supposed to be silent.
Amen.
I want to say, do not be silent.
Amen.
If you are watching, do not be silent. This is the time that you need to praise him. The Bible says, when he was entering, there were people who were like worshipping a king. They took off their coat and threw them inside, in front of the court. And then others behind were praising. To extend that, there was Jerusalem tremble. Can you hear that?
Amen.
There was a noise. We need that holy noise.
Amen. Amen.
You know, I've gathered here with my family so that we go back to the issue of bringing out that holy noise. Praising him with adoration. This is the time that, you know, the praise can break what Satan is doing.
Amen.
This is the time that we need to know that he's around. They knew what he did in Nazareth. They knew what he did in Galilee. And the Bible says, when he entered there, he healed the blind people. And the moment when they saw that he healed the blind people, the Bible says, the chief priests were complaining. They began to hear the boys talking. They say, Hosanna, Hosanna. Where is that Hosanna? This is the time that Hosanna must be louder than the singers. This is the time that we need to know that Jesus is our Savior. Amen.
Amen.
So I want to show you from scriptures what the holy noise can do, which we need today. We need to gather as families.
Amen.
And praise him.
Amen.
We need to call upon him. We need to pray. We need to make the church, that gathering of the church, can work in our lives today.
Amen.
To break this virus, to break what Satan is doing,
Amen.
To break the plan of the enemy.
Amen.
I know that Satan today, he might be very much excited, thinking he's stopping us. But I want to tell you, this is a plan of God for us, that we start from our houses and call upon and praise our God.
Amen.
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 Look at this verse that I was trying to read, especially, you know, when we read about verse 14. And the blind and the lame came to him, and he healed them. But when the chief priest and the scribes and the lawyers, saw the wonderful miraculous things that Jesus had done, and they heard the boys who were shouting, Hosanna to the son of David, the Messiah, they became angry. Satan is not happy when we praise God. Satan is not excited. And then Jesus said something here. He says, it is written in verse Let's read this verse. Maybe that just read verse 16. And they said to him, "Do you hear what these children are saying?" And Jesus replied to them, "Yes, you have read. Out of the mouth of infants and nurses babies, you have prepared and provided praise for yourself." Here you can see that it needs us to have God to be able to praise God.
Amen.
It needs us to praise Him and worship Him and glorify His holy name. And Jesus could not spend more time. He says it's God who has allowed this. This is the time that, you know, what God has allowed from the beginning must work for us. We go back to God, we make noise, we praise Him, and something will happen.
Amen.
Church, don't be quiet this time. Don't be silent this time. Amen.
Amen.
Let me show you from other scriptures concerning being silent. In Exodus chapter 5, if we read from verse 1 to 4, you could hear what He said to Moses. He sent Moses to go and release the Israelites from Egyptians. And then He was talking about He wanted them to do something. Let's go there in Exodus 5 and we read from verse 1 to 4. Exodus 5. Yes. The first one, it says, "Afterward, Moses and Aaron came and said to Pharaoh, 'That says the Lord, the God of Israel, let my people go, so that they may celebrate a feast to me in the wilderness.' But Pharaoh said, 'Who is the Lord that I should obey His voice to let Israel go? I do not know the Lord, nor will I let Israel go.' Then they said, 'The God of Hebrews has met with us. Please, let us go on a 3 days journey into the wilderness and sacrifice to the Lord our God, so that He does not discipline us with pestilence or with the sword.'" You can see here the pestilence and the sword. They need a feast. They need us to go to the wilderness. I believe, we are in a wilderness right now. And for us to get a direction from God, we need just that feast where we celebrate Him, where we worship Him, where we praise Him together. Amen.
Amen.
We need to know that this was the message that was given Moses. If not, the Israelites were supposed to be the slaves forever. They are supposed to be controlled, misled, directed, and suppressed, even depressed in Egypt. But God says, this is the time that you let my people go.
Amen.
The people of God, this is the time that, you know, we celebrate God. If not, this pestilence, this sickness is still going to work. The sickness that we are facing right now just need our praise.
Amen.
When we are celebrating God, praising God, shouting to God, something will happen. Amen.
Amen.
I understand why God spoke with Moses and said, "Go to the wilderness." Because in the wilderness, you know, there's no trace of any direction. Because by the time when there will be a praise in that wilderness, God will begin to direct.
Amen.
We're in the wilderness, we need direction of God. And we cannot get direction of God unless we praise Him. We cannot get direction of God until we take Him as God. Amen.
Amen.
Let me show you another scripture, because I just want to give you some scriptures. Joshua 6. If you read Joshua 6 from verse 1 to 7, you will see what was happening there. You will see that it took the praise and the shouting of the Israelites, the holy shouting, the holy praise, to break down the walls of Jericho. I want to tell you what happened that way. You can see, the Bible says, the people of Jericho were inside, and they already heard about this God of the Jews. They heard about it. The God of Jews have defeated the Egyptians. This God of Jews has opened a road in the River Jordan. And they were the first target. They were on the road. But they knew, they trusted their words. And they remained silent. They just remained silent in Jericho. Amen. I'm sure you're watching. They remained silent in Jericho. And then, when they were silent, God began to speak with Joshua. Joshua, even you be silent, but there will be a time to shout. If these people are silent and you remain silent, you won't do anything. But they are silent. You can't overcome them. And they're on the road to Canaan. This is the journey. And you are facing this obstacle, Jericho. What you have to do, you need to praise God. You need to shout. This is the time that, you know, when I command you to make a noise, make that noise. And that noise will make your enemy to be frustrated.
Amen.
I want to tell you something. Continue what happened there. If you can read, you will see that, you know, today our countries are silent. Everybody is in the house. And everybody is afraid. The same applies like Jericho that was silenced. I mean, all of us were quiet. They're coming to Facebook to tell you what you can do today. On YouTube, I'm telling you what you can do. We can break this wall.
Amen.
The silent enemy needs the shout for the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
You must know that the silent enemy just needs the shout from the Holy Spirit. If we keep silent this time here, we are going to be defeated. We are still going to be turning around these walls without a way. And the Bible says, they were told to shout. And the walls went down. And they took over Jericho. They took over and destroyed. And they were able to move forward.
Amen.
They could not leave Jericho and go aside, because Jericho will follow them behind. Jericho was supposed to be defeated and destroyed, because Jericho was very quiet. Right now we are facing, a silent Jericho. This is a silent Jericho. We cannot be quiet. When we shout here, something will happen. Amen.
Amen.
If we read that on Joshua 6, 2021, we found that people shouted on Joshua 6, 2021. They shouted. Let me just read that verse. I have that verse. You know, Joshua 6. Joshua 6, verse 20. Yes. 20. Yes. It says, so the people shouted. Can you see that verse?
Amen.
To this silent enemy. The people shouted. Here in my Amplified, it says, they heard the battle cry. And the priest blew the trumpets. When the people heard the sound of the trumpet, they raised a great shout, and the wall of Jericho fell down, so that the sons of Israel went up into the city, and every man straight ahead, and they overthrew the city.
Amen.
There's no way we can overcome this silence disease.
Amen.
Except to praise God, to worship God. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
I just want us to read 1 Samuel 4, verse 1 to 9, and see why Phineas was defeated. Why these guys, the children of Eli were defeated. You could see they were defeated because they were not living a right life. When 1 Samuel 4, that's from 1 Samuel 4, from verse 1 to 9. Can you just read that? Can you just read my mind? Just read for me in the Bible. 1 Samuel. Today we are going to shout.
Amen.
We are going to praise God. We are going to call upon God.
Amen.
And we are going to have a blessing.
It says, and the word of Samuel came to all Israel. Now Israel went out to battle against the Philistines and encamped beside Ebenezer. And the Philistines encamped in Aphek. Then the Philistines put themselves in a battle array against Israel. And when they joined battle, Israel was defeated by the Philistines, who killed about 4,000 men of the army in the field. And when the people had come into the camp, the elders of Israel said, why has the Lord defeated us today? Behold, the Philistines, let us bring the Ark of the Covenant of the Lord from Shiloh to us, that when it comes among us, it may save us from the hand of our enemies. So the people sent to Shiloh, that they might bring from there the Ark of the Covenant of the Lord of hosts, who dwells between the cherubims. And the two sons of Eli, Hophni and Phinehas, were there with the Ark of the Covenant of God. And when the Ark of the Covenant of the Lord came into the camp, all Israel shouted so loudly that the earth shook. Now, when the Philistines heard the noise of the shout, they said, what does the sound of this great shout in the camp of the Hebrews mean? Then they understood that the Ark of the Lord had come into the camp. So the Philistines were afraid, for
when I'm listening here, I'm just hearing that, you know, the Israelites here, they came together and then they began to fight the Philistines. But you could see how they were defeated. When they were defeated, they know, oh, we know we have got a one weapon that can make this Philistine to be defeated, was to bring the Ark of the Covenant. Because the Ark of Covenant was representing God. When God is there, and when they shout, something will happen. And the Bible says, when the Ark of God came there, they shouted. When they shout, they were defeated. I want to tell you why they were defeated. Because when you are in sins, and when you please God, your shout strengthens the enemy. The moment when you want to see that your enemy is still going to defeat you, just live a gracious life. When you are in sins, when you shout, when you are praising God, you strengthen the enemy to destroy you. But when you are in holiness, when you shout, you confuse the enemy and defeat him. Therefore, your defeat is in your hands. It's in your ability. How do you walk with God? This is the time now that we need to know how we are walking with God. Here you can see Hophni and Phineas. They were not walking right with God. And they were the ones who were in charge with the Ark of the Covenant. And the Bible shows that they were defeated even when they shouted. Their shouting encouraged the enemy. The Philistine says, we have never had something like this. So let's strengthen ourselves. We cannot be slaves. This is the time now that, you know, we look at our lives, we praise God with holiness. We praise God with righteousness. And something is going to happen.
Amen.
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 Okay, let's leave that scripture. Maybe I can show you another one. I just want to go to New Testament. I was just trying to show you the Old Testament. Old Testament, you can also go to the book of Esther chapter 4. Maybe you can read 13 to 17. Where Mordecai was telling Esther, Esther, you are not as free as you think. You are not as free. Esther 4, 13 to 17. You just read 13.
It says, and Mordecai told them to answer Esther, do not think in your heart that you will escape in the king's palace and more than all the other Jews. For if you remain completely silent at this time, relief and deliverance will arise for the Jews from another place, but you and your father's house will perish. Yet who knows whether you have come to the kingdom for such a time like this?
If you can read there, you'll understand that when whichever position you are in, you are in charge.
Amen.
God places you in times like this. The Bible says you don't know Esther that you have been placed very close to the high authority. The position you are holding, you are the one that you can pray. Okay, can we just read, can you go up? It says what?
Then Esther told them to reply to Mordecai.
Yes.
Go gather all the Jews who are present in Shushan and fast for me, neither eat nor drink for 3 days and night or day. My maids and I will fast likewise, and so I will go to the king, which is against the law. And if I perish, I perish. So Mordecai went his way and did according to all that Esther commanded him.
This was the time that we were supposed to gather all Christians here in Gauteng. This is the time that we were supposed to be saying, all Christians, can we gather now? We pray because we are facing something that will kill us here. Haman was the enemy. The Bible shows that Haman was determined to destroy all the Jews, people of God. He was supposed to destroy all the people of God. And the Bible says, the message came to Esther by Mordecai. Mordecai said to Esther, the position you are in cannot save you. The position you are holding cannot save you except God. This is the time that we fast. This is the time that we make noise and cry to God. This is the time that we need to praise God and pray so that He can save us. Amen.
Amen.
This is the time that, you know, you stand with others. This is not the time that, you know, you just have to hide yourself. It's a time of gathering. He said, the Bible says, gather. You know, when the Bible says gather, you could hear what is happening with our government. They're saying, okay, for the sake of dealing with this COVID-19, it's better you stay in your house. I mean, it cannot stop you not together. Today we are here together as a family. And we are praying, we are praising. Something can happen in our lives.
Amen.
We can still stop this Satan. In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
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 Remember what happened in Acts 1. From verse 9 to 14. I just wanted to look there. You know, what happened there was amazing. Where the Bible says the disciples in Acts 1, 9 to 14. The disciples after Jesus went up to heaven, they were left gazing up. They were gazing up until the revelation came from heaven. The angels came and began to say, hey, you people, this is not the time of looking up. This is not the time of looking at the government. This is not the time. The Bible says, after they received this message, they went back and they came together in upper room. And they were in one accord.
Amen.
Automatically it means they spoke one word. They praise. They worship. They were in one accord.
Amen.
And that is the time where the Bible talks about in Acts chapter 2. If we read from verse 1 to 13, the Bible says the Holy Spirit came mightily like a rushing mighty wind and shake the place. And all of them began to speak in tongues. There was a great noise. What we need today is that is the Holy Spirit. We need the Holy Spirit to come mightily and shake.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Are you ready to receive Holy Spirit?
Amen.
Are you ready to receive Holy Spirit?
Amen.
To shake the power of the enemy.
Amen.
You know, these people, if they could not get the revelation, I don't know what was supposed to have happened to them. Because the Bible says they were facing up. They saw Jesus going. They were still expecting him to come back. But he told them that you can go and wait. But they could not go. They looked up until they got revelation. When the revelation came, they went to the upper room. They could not leave. They were united.
Amen.
They could not leave. Right now, you are in your house and you are feeling to leave. The Spirit of God can locate you there. The power of God can come there.
Amen.
We need that power. We need that unity.
Amen.
We need that strength.
Amen.
To fight against the plan of the enemy.
Amen.
Otherwise, the plan of God will never be fulfilled.
Amen.
I want to show you maybe two last verses and then we close maybe. Acts 4. Let's read 23 to 31. Can you just read that?
And being let go, they went to their own companions and reported all that the chief priests and the elders have said to them. So when they heard that, they raised their voices to God with one accord and said, Lord, you are God, who made heaven and earth, and the sea and all that is in them, who by the mouth of your servants David have said, why did the nations rage and the people plot vain things? The kings of the earth took their stand, and the rulers were gathered together against the Lord and against his Christ. For truly against your holy servants Jesus, whom you anointed both Herod and Pontius Pilate with the Gentiles and the people of Israel, were gathered together to do whatever your hand and your purpose determined before to be done. Now, Lord, look on their threats and grant to your servants that with all boldness they may speak your word by stretching out your hand to heal, and that signs and wonders may be done through your name, of your holy servant Jesus. And when they had prayed, the place where they were assembled together was shaken, and they were all filled with the Holy Spirit, and they spoke the word of God with boldness.
Amen.
Amen.
You know, COVID-19 has brought fear, and also is threatening the church. Because right now, we need to gather together and worship God.
Amen.
Who bring answers to our lives. You will see in this people, the chief priests were having problems.
Amen.
They were having problems. They wanted to silence the gospel.
Amen.
They wanted to stop the church. I have never heard in my life that we cannot go to church because of disease. Our God here is undermined. Our God is seen as a small God. This is the time that, you know, we need to stand together.
Amen.
As a church, we need to believe that the same God of the apostle is our God.
Amen.
We need to believe that. Like I said initially, I was saying, when Jesus was still around, there was a time where there were diseases like leprosy. You could touch the lepers and they were healed. But if you look around now, you will see that if this leprosy was around, we were supposed to run away and save ourselves. You could see the threats against the church. It is not the government that is threatening the church. The sickness. Just to hear about the sickness is threatening the church. We need to know that now we are free of sickness. Whereas Jesus can heal all the sickness. These people were told that you can go back and stop talking about Jesus. And the Bible says, they said, we are not going back and stop. They reported the issue that we were told to stop to talk about Jesus. And the Bible says, in one accord, they raised their voices to God. In other words, they shouted. They could not be silenced. They came out praising God and called upon God and say, the church is the body of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
And if we call upon you, you will answer us. And the Bible says, like before, the place where they were standing began to shake. And automatically it means, even there, where they were, the people were threatening them. When the place where they were was shaking because of the prayers that were offered by the disciples, by the apostles. Amen.
Amen.
And the Bible says, from there, they were filled with the Holy Spirit. For them to faint, for them to have fear, they spoke the word of God with boldness. This is the time that, you know, the word of God must prevail from our mouth. This is the time that we need to stand as Christians and pray. We can stand in our families. We can stand in our gatherings. I pray that God is going to help us to understand that it's only Him who can solve this problem.
Amen.
I want to say to our people who are watching, I know that Satan's plan is originated from people. When Satan wants to do things, he speaks with people. I want to say to some people who believe that God cannot solve this, it's only God who can heal disease.
Amen.
It's only God who can help us on this situation.
Amen.
So we cannot be silent this time. The disciples could not be silent. We cannot be silent. I'm praying that today we understand this God the same way we understand Him. If we all understand it the same way the apostle understood it, we are going to get answers from above.
Amen.
Look what happened in Acts 16 from verse 20. I will stop there. I don't want you to be silent.
Amen.
Acts 16 from verse 20. You could see the praise in prison. Okay, just read from verse 20.
And they brought them to the the magistrate and said, these men, the Jews, exceedingly trouble our city, and they teach customs which are not lawful for us, being Romans, to receive or observe. Then the multitude rose up together against them, and the magistrate tore off their clothes and commanded them to be beaten with rods. And when they had laid many stripes on them, they threw them into prison, commanding the jailer to keep them securely. Having received such a charge, he put them into the inner prison and fastened their feet in the stocks. But at midnight, Paul and Silas were praying and singing hymns to God, and the prisoners were listening to them. Suddenly, there was a great earthquake, so that the foundation of the prison was shaken, and immediately all the doors were opened and everyone's chains were loosened. And the keeper of the prison, awakening from the sleep and seeing the prison doors open, supposing the prisoners had fled, drew his sword and was about to kill himself. But Paul called with a loud voice, saying, do yourself no harm, for we are all here.
Can I go for this?
Then he called for a light, ran in, and fell down trembling before Paul and Silas. And he brought them out and said, sirs, what must I do to be saved? So they said, believe on the Lord Jesus Christ, and you will be saved, you and your household. Then they spoke the word of the Lord to him and to all who were in his house. And he took them the same hour of the night and washed their stripes, and immediately he and all were baptized. Now, when he had brought them in the house, he set food before them, and he rejoiced, having believed in God with all his household.
Can you hear these guys, Paul and Silas, who were in prison, arrested, beaten, by mere making that holy noise? What happened? They were supposed to have kept quiet and look at what happened to them. They had, they've experienced, but they told themselves, in the midnight when everybody's asleep, let's use this time just to worship God and pray, and something will happen. And that noise brought salvation to the keeper of the jail. Someone needs to be saved this time. He just needs us not to be silent. If we are silent, Satan is still going to win many. Many will never know God. This man never knew that Paul and Silas were Christians. And Paul and Silas never even preached to him. It's only the chains when they went down and the place that was shaking brought a conviction to this man. Today we are afraid of what we cannot see.
Amen.
Today we are afraid of what we cannot see. Today when someone wants to shake hands, you have to be afraid because of the information we have been given. We are afraid because of the information, not because, you know, we have seen that. This is the time that God can still work wonders and stop this violence. This is the time that when we pray, we worship God. I mean, how can we be afraid of what we cannot see? We need to worship God with calling. We know other people are sick right now of the same sickness, and we believe God is healing them.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
We believe there are many people right now who have really lost their loved ones, but we know God is stopping this virus in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
We believe that our government, God will give them wisdom against these violence.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Because we understand that it's only when we shout, we praise, the chains will go down. The chains of Satan. Right now, the church is chained. The church is chained now. If I go out to say, let's go to church, we have to be arrested. The church is chained. According to the laws and the regulations, the church is not supposed to be there because the disease can spread. But this disease, we don't know where it's going now. This is the time that we can call upon God to stop this disease.
Amen.
By praising Him.
Amen.
By worshiping God.
Amen.
By glorifying His holy name.
Amen.
If you believe, shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
If you are watching there, don't allow Satan to give you false information. This is the time of seeing worship and praise as important in your life.
Amen.
I've never felt missing church like this. Missing church. Where there will be that noise, you know, where people are worshiping. Because in heaven, it's like that. Before God, 24 elders, right, falling down before God, worshiping. Noise, you are holy. Today, the disease has stopped us.
Amen.
So this is the time of showing that this disease, by our praise, by our worship, we can stop this sickness.
Amen.
I'm praying that those who are sick will be healed in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
And today, even you who don't know the importance of accepting Jesus, or who don't know Jesus, today you can accept Him to be your Lord and Savior.
Amen.
You can tell yourself, it's only God. We need Him. I can give you an example. I've been telling people that I've never seen the way we are afraid of sickness. I've never seen. Because whether we are run away from sickness, one day we will die. Whether we run away from sickness, one day we will die. Where are we going to spend our eternity? Where are we going to spend our eternity? Yes, we are not supposed to die like we don't have knowledge. God has given us wisdom, it's true. But the way, you know, we are staying home, the way when you drive around, you cannot see cars, you cannot see anything. The way it's happening, if people will obey God that way, what will happen? If really we fear God that way, what will happen? Today, we're supposed to be having to be a good citizen. Our country was supposed to be nurtured in a good way. We're supposed to be having good results in our lives. Amen.
Amen.
So I'm praying that today you see the importance of accepting Jesus. And if you want to accept Jesus, you can still stretch forth your hand towards me and we pray this prayer. Can you just pray with them, Mama? A prayer of accepting Jesus. Those who are stretching forth their hands wherever you are. Stretch your hand. Close your eyes. Yes.
Let us all say, Father, in the name of Jesus, we come back to you. We acknowledge that we are sinners.
We acknowledge that we are sinners.
We know that you will save us.
Because
we know
that
in the name of Jesus,
who
has died for us, we have life. From today, we believe in you.
We
want to trust in you.
We
want to follow you.
We
want to praise you all the days of our lives. In Jesus' mighty name, we are repenting from our sins and we want to be your children.
I want to be your
Thank you for salvation.
Thank you for salvation.
In Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name.